In this video, we will be discussing how to perform a goodness of fit hypothesis test in Google Sheets. Let's begin. To do a hypothesis test for goodness of fit, we will want to start with a blank Google Sheets document, and we will want to start by filling in these first two columns and the label for the third column. So we can start anywhere. And just go category and just start labeling things. Not really the most important part of this. Oh. And then observed. I'm just going to put observed. And then here's expected. And we're going to put in these values here. Now the expected is based on what's given at the very beginning of the problem. So we're conducting a goodness fit hypothesis test for the claim that the four categories occur with the following frequencies. So we have these decimals here. This represents the proportion that are in each category. So what we want to do first, before we find the expected, is we want to find this total. We'll make a total column. We'll go equals sum, and we'll sum up this column here, close parentheses, hit enter, and we'll have the sum of this column, 108. Now the expected is based off that total, and we're going to multiply it by each of these proportions. And then this is equal to 108 multiplied by 0.2. This is equal to 108 multiplied by 0.2. And this is equal to 108 multiplied by 0.3. So this will give us the same total. I'll copy this formula over. So if we sum up this column right here, we'll still have 108. But now the proportion in each category for the expected based on the proportion that we're claiming. So this is now 30%, so 0.3, 20%, 20%, 30% of the 108. And this is the actual data, the observed. Now we want to make a new column. This new column is going to be the observed minus expected. Actually, that's O minus expected. And we're going to square that and divide it by E. And just so you know, this is the O and this is the E. There's another name for this. This is also known as the squared Pearson residual. Squared Pearson residual. Oops. Or it's also there's also a name, another name for it, which is just squared residual. So that's two different names for the column we're about to make right here. This formula gives us the squared Pearson residual. And so what we want to do is go equals, and now each category will have a squared Pearson residual value. We're going to do equals the observed minus the expected, close parentheses. Now we're going to square it and divide it by the expected. There's the squared Pearson residual or squared residual of the category A. And we'll copy the formula down. And we have the following. So these are the squared Pearson residual or the squared residual values for each of the categories. Now, if we sum up this column right here, the sum of this column is 5.966. That is chi-squared, that this value right here, the chi-squared test statistic. So I'll just write the chi-squared test statistic. I'll put equals. That is just equal to that value we just found. That is the chi-squared test statistic, is the sum of all the squared residuals. So now we can also find the p-value. The p-value is 's equal to, using the function chi dist. And what we enter into this chi dist is the chi-squared test statistic is the first thing we enter in. That's our x that goes in there. And then the degrees of freedom is the number of categories that we have. So A, B, C, and D, minus one. So there's four categories, minus one is three. So there is the p-value. So, I also mentioned the degrees of freedom, which is df, is equal to the number of categories minus one, in this case, three. Just list that out too. So there's the chi-squared test statistic. So right here, this is 5.966. The p-value is 0.113. And for a significant test alpha equals 0.025, since the p-value is larger than alpha, like any hypothesis test, if the p-value is larger than alpha, then we fail to reject the null hypothesis. So that is how you perform a chi-squared goodness of fit test using Google Sheets.